Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see the different modes of failure, or we can say the different methods of failure. Now in case of modes of failure, the first one is ductile failure. Now in case of ductile failure, let us consider a rod. And through the axis of the rod, load is applied, and this load is tensile, that is tensile load is applied. So now under the action of this tensile load, what changes we are going to see? That because of tensile load applied, the length of rod will increase. As we can see here, when the load is tensile, the length of this rod will increase, but the diameter of the rod will decrease. And next, I'll draw the different stages, how it will look like. So here, when the load is tensile, length will go on increasing, diameter will go on reducing slightly. Next, there will be further reduction in area. Area will go on reducing, and then if there are internal holes present, because of the action of the tensile load, these internal holes, they will combine, and there will be further reduction in the dimensions. And here, as we can see, there is a neck formation. A neck has been formed, that is the diameter has reduced to such a value that there is a very small diameter left. And further, if we are applying the load, that will result in a cup and cone arrangement. That is, now when the load has been increased, this neck will break into two halves and it will look like this, and this results in the fracture of the material forming cup and cone arrangement. So this is the ductile failure. Next, brittle failure. Now in case of brittle failure, here I'll assume that there is a block made up of some brittle material, like for example wood or concrete. Now over this block, which is a brittle material, load is applied. And the nature of the load is compressive. Now, if we are applying compressive load, then brittle materials, they are stronger in compression. But if I change the nature of loading, that is, on this same block, if I reverse the direction of loading, instead of compression, if we have tensile loading, previously it was subjected to compressive load and now it is subjected to tensile load. So under the action of this tensile load, since the material is brittle, I can say that because of tensile load, applied to the block. Brittle fracture takes place without any prior warning. That is, when the tensile load is applied, because of that there is direct brittle fracture without any prior warning. Because if we see previously, when there was ductile failure, we could see the change in shape, the change in dimensions was visible, and finally the object was broken. But in case of ductile materials, it is a direct fracture, that is without any indication. So after breaking, the material will be somewhat like this, and this is called as brittle fracture. So here in this video, we have seen what is the mode of failure.